Hi, my name is Dan Witt from the University of Utah College of Pharmacy, and we're going to be giving you some information today about how and when to restart anticoagulants after a major bleeding episode. One thing that's important to remember is that anticoagulants themselves do not cause bleeding, but they certainly exacerbate bleeding from existing sources. And so a fundamental thing that we need to remember when addressing this problem is trying to locate and correct any potential causes of bleeding. And that'll help us feel a little bit more secure about our decision to resume anticoagulant therapy once that bleeding is corrected. I want to focus a little bit on gastrointestinal bleeding. This is certainly the most common type of bleeding that's going to be experienced in anticoagulated patients. And we've got some accumulating evidence from observational trials that would indicate that the risk of recurrent bleeding, if anticoagulation therapy is resumed, is not statistically significantly increased following resumption of therapy. However, failure to reinstitute anticoagulation therapy is going to be placing patients who are at high risk for thromboembolism at risk for potential further complications. And so, as this slide illustrates there, the real benefit of resuming anticoagulation therapy is a reduction in overall mortality and thromboembolic complications without an increase in the risk for recurrent bleeding. Another issue that needs to be talked about is the timing of resumption. And this Kaplan-Meier plot would indicate that if we start anticoagulation therapy too soon following a bleeding event, we run the risk of increasing recurrent GI bleeding. And so it appears that we need to wait at least 7 days before resumption, but we don't want to wait too much longer than that, somewhere in the 7 to 14 day window to resume therapy. So just to summarize what we know about GI tract bleeding, at this time, there's a lot of evidence accumulating from observational trials that would support that resuming anticoagulation therapy reduces the risk of thromboembolism and overall mortality without increasing the risk for recurrent GI bleeding. The optimal timing seems to be about 7 to 14 days following the bleeding episode, and you need to take other factors into consideration, like the severity of the bleeding event, whether or not you're able to locate and treat that, and also underlying thromboembolic risks. A couple of things that we need more information about is which agent to resume. Should we resume a direct oral anticoagulant versus warfarin therapy? And we need more information to indicate which might be the best choice there. We also don't have a whole lot of information about whether this information also applies to other sites of bleeding other than the gastrointestinal tract. Intracranial hemorrhage is probably one of the most feared complications of anticoagulant therapy. And similar to GI tract bleeding, the information is looking as though that resuming anticoagulant therapy, as is illustrated here in this forest plot diagram of a systematic review of several recent observational trials, the risk of recurrent intracranial hemorrhage does not seem to be elevated when resuming anticoagulation therapy. However, resuming therapy does reduce the risk of having subsequent ischemic stroke, and similar to what we were just talking about with GI bleeding, the risk of all-cause mortality is reduced as well. When we're trying to make a decision about whether to resume therapy, there's several things that should be weighed in the balance, some bleed-related characteristics that might indicate weighing in favor of resuming therapy, particularly if you can identify the source and correct the source. When we're talking about intracranial hemorrhaging, lobar location might argue against resumption because of a higher tendency for rebleeding, but it's not an absolute contraindication to resuming therapy either. Higher risk of thromboembolism in the underlying situation is also factored into the mix. And patients that have higher risks of thromboembolism, we should weigh in favor of resuming therapy, versus patients who no longer have a need for anticoagulant therapy. And then also just the ease with which we can manage anticoagulant therapy needs to be taken into the balance as well. So to sum up all of these things, the default plan should be when your patient experiences major bleeding on anticoagulant therapy to think about resuming that therapy. Using bleed-related factors and other underlying thromboembolic risk factors and comorbidities, you can then make a decision to try to refute that decision to resume the anticoag therapy. But in most cases, I think the plan should be to resume. And for GI bleeding, it looks like 7 to 14 days is optimal. A little less clear with intracranial hemorrhaging, and also whether or not to switch to direct oral anticoagulant or to use warfarin therapy needs further information. Thank you for listening.